2x plus 1 equals to 0 is an equation, and we can solve this equation. We can find x equals to minus 1 by 2. So an equation means we find the unknown value and we call it the root of the equation. And we can have other versions of this. We can have x squared minus 4 equals to 0. This is a quadratic equation. This was a linear equation. That means we will have two values of x here. So we can write x squared equals to 4, therefore x equals to plus minus square root of 4. So we have two values of x. X equals to plus root 4 is 2 or minus 2. So when we have a linear equation, we have one value of x. And when we have a quadratic equation, we have two values of x. We can also have cubic equation and on and on. So an equation means the relationship between an unknown quantity x with a known quantity. Here, double the unknown quantity increased by 1 is 0. And that's how we find the unknown value. When we have two unknown values, for example, y equals to 2x plus 1, or y equals to x squared minus 4, both are equations, but this is a bit different. This particular equation has two unknown values. So we call this a Cartesian equation. Cartesian equation. And there's a difference between these two. The only difference is that here we have a 0 over here and here we have another unknown value. So the formal definition of equation is, an equation is, it's made up of numbers, unknown symbols like x, variables, and algebraic arithmetic operations, and equal to sign. That's it. In case of Cartesian equation is made up of two unknown variables, numbers, of arithmetic operations, and equal to sign. So that's the major difference. So what do we do to a Cartesian equation? Well, we think of two number lines. One number line is a horizontal number line, we call it the x-axis, and number line is a bunch of numbers on a line, and we have a vertical number line, we call it y, and the two number lines meet at a point called the origin, and this forms some sort of a rectangular plane, and every position over here has two addresses, like a rectangle. It means how far do you go starting from the origin towards left or right, or upwards and downwards. So if I say that this point has a x value and a y value, it means starting from the origin you go to the left and you go upwards. For example, if I want to put the value of 1, 3, so you start from the origin and you go 1 and then you go up 3. So this, suppose this point is 1, 3 and that's it. Now you get a picture from these points by joining points. So suppose if I put here x equals to 0, we get a value of y as 1. So we get a point 0, 1. And if I put x equals to 2, we get 5, y equals to 5. So we can think of this as 0, 1. So if x is 0, this is x and this is y. So if this is 0, y is 1. So the point over here is here, 0, 1. And when x is 2, if I put here 2, then y is 5, somewhere around here, 2, 5. And we can join the two as much as we want. And that's it. That's the picture. That's what the line looks like. So every particular Cartesian equation has a particular picture. Now, instead of plotting all the way, we can just memorize it. Just remember this. When we think of a Cartesian equation, it's like a machine. This machine gives us points. And using the points, we can get pictures. So it's a Cartesian equation gives us points, lots and lots of points. And a point is made up of two values, one value of x and one value of y. We write it with open bracket and close bracket. It's like an ordered pair. And with this bunch of points, we get pictures by joining the points together. We don't have to think about joining them. Just we can memorize it like a vocabulary. We get pictures. There are two types of pictures. Lines, which are only produced by linear Cartesian equations in the form of x to the power 1, or curves. Only these are lines, y equals to x plus b, but everything else, they are curves. The difference between line and curve are the turning points. Curves turns at a point. We call it the turning point. Lines don't turn at all. Lines are fixed. They move in a particular direction. We can say they have a fixed gradient, a special property. Curves turns means they don't have any fixed properties. So it's worth remembering what are the most common pictures, how we do it. So let's take a look. Now the general pictures are like that. Y equals to AX plus B. This is a first degree polynomial. It has a particular picture, and generally speaking they look like this. If A is positive, then we have Y equals to AX squared plus BX plus C. These are general quadratics and they look like a parabola. Then we have cubic polynomial, Y equals to X cubed plus BX squared plus CX plus D. Generally speaking, they look like this when A is positive. Then apart from the polynomials, so these are the three polynomials. Apart from the polynomials, we have the exponential, A to the power X, or more particularly, this constant is, we take it as E, 2.7. So E to the power X. So generally speaking, they look like this. There is a asymptote and we have this shape. That's what this looks like. Then we have Y equals to log base AX, but more specifically the base is E, so we write it ln X, and this is what the picture, generally speaking, this is what the shape looks like. This is a vertical asymptote. And then we have more general shape, Y equals to something sine X. It looks like this, like this value. It looks like the shape is like this. We can think of the line over here, the x-axis over here. This is what it looks like. Then we have Y equals to cos X, and Y equals to cos X, the shape looks like this. So we can all put values of X and get a value of Y. Remember, the equations are point generating machines. We get lots and lots of points and we join the points and get some pictures. Here we're talking about sketching so that you can memorize the general shape. So these are general shape. What would happen is that if we know the specific values of A and B, we can get the specific pictures. So let me, it's handy, some of the most common specific sketches. It'll give you an idea how it works. So let me show you. So if I take this, so this is general shape. Y equals to AX plus B is the general shape. If I take B equal to 0 and A equals to 1, the specific shape becomes Y equals to X. So Y equals to X looks like this. If this is X-axis, this is Y-axis, this is the origin, it goes straight through. That's it, memorize the picture. It'll come in handy. Now, if we have Y equals to AX squared plus BX plus C, if I put C equals to 0, B equals to 0, and A equals to 1, so the specific picture becomes X Y equals to X squared. And we call this the basic parabola, and this is what it looks like. Just memorize it. The next one is a cubic, Y equals to AX cubed plus BX squared plus CX plus D. So if I put D equal to 0, C equal to 0, B equal to 0, and A equals to 1, we get a cubic picture, Y equals to X cubed, and specifically, this is what the shape looks like. Memorize this. It will be very useful. So this is what the shape looks like. Now, we have the general shape, so Y equals to e to the power X. I'm not writing A e to the power BX or anything, just Y equals to e to the power X looks like this. We have, this is very specific, this is X-axis, this is Y-axis, this is the origin, and it becomes parallel like this. This is what it looks like. And remember, this is the Y-axis, so at the Y number line there is no value of X. X equal to 0, if I put X equal to 0, e to the power 0 is 1, so I put here 1. Now it's worth noting that here the x-axis, if I don't give the x-axis and only the y-axis, the picture would look like this. The picture looks like this. This is the y-axis, this is the origin. So this is a magnetic field like of a thing. We call it the asymptote. Now we have Y equals to ln X, another specific picture. So this time it is like this. And this is, now when you put here, this is the x-axis, this is the y-axis, this thing becomes 1. Again, if I, this time, if I draw only the x-axis and not the y-axis, here the magnetic, you know, field, or what can I, let me call it the broken line. It's here. We can see it now. So this is one. So these are specific pictures worth remembering. So we have so far five pictures. Two more. Let me show you two more. Y equals to sine x is another specific picture, trigonometry. And this is what it looks like. X-axis, y-axis starting from zero. This is what it looks like. And the picture is usually from 0 to 360 degree. And the highest point is 1 and the lowest point is minus 1. Just memorize this picture. Then we have y equals to cosine x or cos x. Here the picture looks a bit similar. They're part of the sinusoidal curve. Sine x, cos x, they go on like this. One snapshot is sine x, which is from here to here. And another snapshot is cos x, which is from here to here. So they're actually part of the same picture. So the picture looks like this. Again, from 0 to 360 degree. This is plus 1. And this is minus 1. So these are specific sketches. There's one more specific sketch I would like to talk about. And it's a reciprocal. It's a fraction. It's a rational picture. So y equals to 1 by x. So this is a specific picture. And they're made up of, they're like hyperbola. It's like this is one boomerang shape. This is another boomerang shape. And they're similar to the e to the power x and ln x pictures. If I remove both the y-axis and the x-axis, this is what it looks like. This is one of the asymptote. And this is another broken line, another asymptote. And this is what the picture looks like without the x-axis and y-axis. The x-axis and y-axis sort of hides the shapes. That's what happens. So these are the specific pictures that you need to know. So let me do a very quick review. So the first specific picture is the linear y equals to x. So the picture looks like this. The next one is y equals to x squared, a parabola. The picture looks like this. Always remember to label the x-axis and the y-axis and the origin. That's very important. The next one is y equals to x cubed, and the specific picture looks like this. Now, the next one is y equals to e to the power x, and e to the power x looks like this. Remember, there's an asymptote that is hidden by this line, x-axis, which is also known as the line y equals to 0. When you have y equals to ln x, this picture looks like this, and it cuts here at 1, and e to the power x cuts here at 1, and here the asymptote is the vertical line. Now, we have the next one is y equals to sine x. So, y equals to sine x looks like this. We have this axis. This is what it looks like. The highest point is 1 and the lowest point is minus 1. The next one is y equals to cosine x or cos x, and x-axis, y-axis. This is what it looks like. So this is 1 and this is minus 1.